On August 29th, 1997, Skynet, a computer system built to protect us, became self-aware. It viewed humanity as a threat to its existence and decided to act. Judgment Day, as we eventually called it, marked the beginning of the war against the machines. Skynet attacks happened almost daily, but the attack that happened on that day was like nothing we'd seen before.
Come on, come on. Where are the others? Where's the rest of the resistance?
I don't know.
No! Listen to me, if you
want.
Get under that bus now. Hey, move, quick.
I'm through. This is Private Jacob.
I know who you are. There's an evacuation point on the other side of town. You need to get there.
scouts ahead. Keep that gun ready. Or sneak past them if you don't want to engage.
There. Hello?
Kiddo.
I don't want to go with you.
No, you don't, but we can't stay here.
Who's there?
Oh, thank God. You're from the Resistance.
See, Patrick? He's going to help us.
No, they're going to get us.
Please, you need to help me. My little brother, he just won't listen.
I'm not going. Leave me alone. I said leave me alone.
I know you're scared, but staying here is not an option. I'll protect you and your sister, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. I'm Jennifer, by the way.
I've heard there's an evacuation point near here.
Yeah, I know. My people are organizing it. We're heading there right now. I'll take us there. Come on, let's go. Where's the rest of the Resistance?
I don't know. I came here looking for them myself.
So it's just you then? This way!
I thought Pasadena was safe.
It was, until all the soldiers were pulled out from the area. Through here!
Terminators!
Get down! Get down!
What's going on?
Shh.
Aaron said these attacks happen more often as the line gets closer.
This Aaron, has she seen the Annihilation Line?
Seen it? She's been on the other side of it. We're here.
How gracious of you to finally join us. Where's your father?
He's not coming.
God damn it. Tell Ryan that we need to leave, now!
Oh, you're from the Resistance. Thank you for making sure that Jennifer and Patrick got here safe.
Are you the guy I spoke to on the radio?
Nah, I don't think so. I haven't been able to reach anybody for a while now, but listen. I know that Colin wants us to go, but I don't know how I feel about leaving anyone behind. Jennifer just got here, and you said yourself that you heard someone on the radio. There could be other people out there. Don't you think somebody should go and look for them? I mean, you're from the Resistance. It's your call.
I'll search for other survivors.
Good. I'll get the bus ready. Before you go, talk to Erin. She might be able to get you a med kit. Oh, and take this. You'll probably need it.
Colin, where are you? Can you hear me?
Be quiet! I'm following that guy. Something's not right about him.
To me, Colin!
Jacob Rivers, marked for termination.
Are you all right, Jacob? Jacob!
Thank you.
Hours later, they found me lying in front of our hideout. I made it out alive, but not all of us did. Colin's dead, and the stranger I saw is nowhere to be found. I told them about everything. I said that it wasn't safe for them to be with me. But Jennifer suggested that right now, nowhere is safe, so we might as well stick together. Everyone pulled through as we prepared for the worst. But nothing happened.
Jacob? Are you awake?
How long have you been sitting there?
Not that long. I know that you're going to that hospital today, so I went on my first scavenging run. And I found something for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Did you go with your sister?
No. As soon as Erin heard that there's a hospital nearby, she asked Jennifer to go look for some medicine. So I went alone. Don't tell her that, okay?
She's already at the medical district?
Yep. Oh, and Ryan wanted to talk to you.
Heat from a plasma rifle cauterized the wound. That's why he's not bleeding. But damage to the skin made the burn prone to infection. That's what we need to worry about.
Wow. You're really smart.
I learned all that before the war. And thanks to Judgment Day, I didn't even have to pay off my student loan.
You wanted to see me.
You're finally here. Good. I have a special task for you. I want you to head downtown to check on the doctor.
Doctor?
Alvin. He's out there making sure that our defense systems are working properly. Ever since we went radio silent, I had a small team of trustworthy messengers maintaining communication between our outposts. They haven't returned, so I want you to go downtown and see why that happened. Could be nothing. But Connor doesn't want any hiccups while he's up there in North Division preparing the attack on Skynet's Central Core.
If you don't mind me asking, how did you end up here?
Excuse me if I act a little surprised, Sergeant. But no one in here thinks it's wise to ask their superior personal questions. But since you did, I'll humor you. So, how did I get here? The same way you did. I was born, raised, then given a gun. We don't really have a say in what we do, do we? Or do I assume too much? Was it any different for you? Why do you fight, Sergeant?
It's the right thing to do.
There's nothing noble in what we do. Humans were fighting humans since the beginning of time. It just so happens that right now we have a common enemy. If it wasn't for the machines, we'd probably be fighting each other.
If that's how you view humanity, are we even worth fighting for?
I'm just doing whatever it takes to survive. Saving humanity is just a bonus. Besides, I'm not a fighter. When I go out there in the middle of the night with my Westinghouse, I'm not looking for a fight. I look to seek and conquer. I'm not a fighter. I'm a bully.
What's the difference?
I don't treat them as equals. And although I know they're just machines, I want them to fear me. No one ever stands up to bullies. But I have to admit, it has its downsides. One of them being that no one ever asks me a personal question. At least not since Perry died. So congratulations, Rivers. Takes guts to stand up to a bully. I guess since your promotion, you got a little more cocky. Good for you.
Is there a problem with the radio?
The Annihilation Line is within spitting distance of downtown. We suspect that Skynet will be intercepting all transmissions from that location. So for now, we're going radio silent. That's why I need you to go there personally.
Central Core?
Skynet's main reactor, the source of all their power. We shut down the Central Core, we shut down Skynet. Connor's preparing the attack as we speak. So you understand we can't have any critical complications at this stage.
We need a medic over here!
I'm telling you, I saw something.
Sergeant, we're outnumbered, and they keep bringing more wounded. We don't stand a chance. We have to evacuate.
Is Alvin still there?
He is, sir.
Then we're not leaving. We have to bring him back and see what the hell is going on with those defenses, and brief Commander Baron on what's happening here. I'm moving out. You stay here with the wounded.
You want me to break the radio silence?
At this point, it doesn't matter, does it?
Understood. Go ahead, sir.
You two follow me. We have to reach those defense systems.
Yes, sir.
Spiders up ahead! Got it! Lead the way! This way!
Good to see you, Sergeant.
What's the status?
We've got a defensive perimeter set up just down the road.
Doesn't seem to be working.
Skynet dropped reinforcements behind their back. Now they're between a rock and a hard place.
Alright, we need to reach our guys. Let's clear the way.
Thank you.
Keep moving!
Here they come!
Rescue the dog before those tanks reach us! Shit! We're too late! They're already here! Doctor! Alvin! Oh my god! I'm actually glad to see you! What happened here? Why are the defense systems not working?
They are working, but their target filtering has been reset to non-hostile. One of Baron's messengers came with the order to temporarily change it, so I did!
Baron's messengers. We need to leave now.
Yes, let's do that. I'm all for that.
Are you all right? We need to move.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Escort secured.
Go!
Oh my god! I'm actually glad to see you!
What happened here? Why are the defense systems not working?
They are working, but their target filtering has been reset to non-hostile. One of Baron's messengers came with the order to temporarily change it, so I did!
Baron's messengers. We need to leave now.
Yes, let's do that. I'm all for that.
Are you all right? We need to move.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Escort secured.
Go!
I don't like this! I don't like any of this!
Ariel! Okay, go!
It's turning around! It's right behind us!
Don't look back!
Good idea! You go talk to Commander Baron. I've had enough excitement for one day. Hey, are you all right? We just got the news about the attack. They're getting closer, aren't they?
Hey, glad to see you alive. Thanks for sticking your neck out for us. I wanted to tell you that, you know, just in case.
Lay still. Don't move.
Thanks for getting us out of there, Sergeant.
What's up?
I know you're busy, but I found something. Something I think you'll like. A tape from back in the day. I want to play it for you, but my boombox is busted. So if you're out there and find one that works, bring it to me, okay?
Can't you ask Jennifer or one of the other scavengers for help?
I already did, but they couldn't find anything. Just think about it, okay?
Jacob.
What's in your mind?
Ever since you asked me about Peter, I can't stop thinking about him. Like a teenage girl. That's your fault, young man.
Are you thinking about anything in particular?
About the day we first met. It was long before Judgment Day. I was getting coffee on my way to school. I noticed him because he was buying tea in a coffee shop. I don't know why, but that made me smile. Maybe it's stupid. Maybe I should stop thinking about him. He's probably dead by now. God knows he can't take care of himself.
Do you want to find him?
Sometimes I think I should drop everything and go. I would get an earful from Baron, but she's nothing I can't handle. Anyway, what I didn't tell you before is that during Judgment Day, I lost a child. Our child. I don't know if it would have happened anyway, but I like to blame the machines for that. I think that Peter felt with Taylor we were given a second chance. God, he's still out there waiting for me, isn't he? Probably sitting in his rocking chair back in our house in Hollywood Hills. Oh, where the hell are you, Peter?
How are the wounded doing?
The few that came back, they're doing fine. We patched them up, and at this point we're just sitting and waiting.
Rivers, you want to explain to me what the hell happened?
We lost downtown.
I know that much. But how's that possible? What happened to our defense systems?
Alvin says one of our soldiers came with an order directly from you to reset the target settings for non-lethals.
He said what? All right. This is what I want you to do. Find whoever is responsible for sending that order. All the messengers have GPS tracking, so we're keeping tabs on their location. Find them and bring them to me.
Understood.
And Rivers, despite what I might say about our resident egghead, I truly have a hard time believing that my men are incompetent. So expect the unexpected. And you know what I mean by that.
Do you think the infiltrator's back?
We won't be sure until you find those messengers and confirm my suspicion. As soon as you know what's going on, radio me.
Who's Perry? You mentioned him before.
The best soldier I ever fought beside. He was the one who brought me into the Resistance. It's actually a funny story. Years ago, when I was just a kid, I saw a Skynet drone attacking some guy. Without thinking, I grabbed a rock and jumped on it. The guy was screaming the whole time while I beat the metal to the ground. Only when I was done did I realize he was trying to stop me.
Seems you were a tough kid.
Life didn't exactly soften me much. To survive, I embraced the savage it made me. He was a resistance scientist, and that drone was one of his projects. So you can imagine he wasn't too happy when I smashed it to pieces. But he wasn't alone. There was this huge guy with a rifle on his shoulder, almost choking with laughter. It sure made his day.
Way to make a good first impression.
Sure is. That scientist later told me that was the first time he ever heard Perry laugh. Somehow, Perry and I connected. He taught me how to channel my anger and get it under control. He introduced me to Connor, and that's how I got to the 132nd.
Whatever happened to Perry?
Skynet got hold of our position. We had to leave our shelter. There were a lot of casualties, and he was one of them. He died a soldier. I'd never thought I'd be reminiscing about the day I met them. This may come as a surprise to you, but it was the first medal I ever destroyed.
Sounds like you were late in joining the Destroy Skynet campaign.
Before that, it was people, not machines. But that's a different story.
You want me to break radio silence?
They have a head start on us. At this point, we can't afford to lose any time.
They won't fucking die!
Shoot!
Thank you.
Commander! We got it. We finally got it.
Good job, Rivers. Stay there. We're on our way.
There was no doubt anymore. Skynet had created a cybernetic organism. It was designed to blur the line between a man and a machine. People started to think that there were Terminators amongst us, wolves in sheep's clothes. Some of us left, even though we hadn't seen any other infiltrators yet. Or at least, we didn't think we had. And that fear of not knowing was what turned the tide of this war. That night, Skynet won.
I still have to run some tests, so for now I would say no.
We need some more time, Connor.
I know you don't want to hear this, Commander, but if there's one person who can help us, it's Dr. Mack.
Mack? We don't even know if he's alive.
He is. He's in the Hollywood Hills. We knew a time would come when we'd need him again, so we've kept an eye on him.
Wait. You've been watching him without telling me?
You let your emotions cloud your judgment before, Commander. That's why I decided that Mac's whereabouts were no longer
your
concern. This
is bullshit. He can't just magically fix all of our problems. He's a man, not a god. A man that makes mistakes.
That's enough, Commander.
You know what happened last time. He's the reason Perry's dead.
I said that's enough. Sergeant Rivers?
Yes, sir.
TechCom believes that being marked for termination is a badge of honor. A sign that we're doing something right. We wear it proudly. And knowing you're wearing such a badge, Rivers, is all I need to trust you with handling this mission. Commander Barron will fill you in on the details. Good luck, soldier. Over and out.
Looks like you're going to Hollywood Hills. Dr. Edwin Mack is the one who taught us how to use Skynet's weapons, so there's a chance he can do it again. Take him that second-generation plasma rifle and see if he's able to reprogram it. If we want to use Skynet's weapons, we need to bypass their encryption lockouts.
How will I find him?
He's obsessed with surveillance. So when you get there, look for any cameras, biometric sensors, or any other tech stuff. He should be around. That's it.
Sure, let's trust someone who gets called Dr. Death. That won't bite us in the ass. In the meantime, I'll see what I can learn from the new CPU we acquired from that infiltrator. This could be the breakthrough that we've all been waiting for. I need to concentrate, so please don't disturb me.
What do you need?
Was Mac the one whose drone you smashed?
Yes. Yes, it was. I've never told this to anyone, but before I met Mac and Perry, I was wandering alone. Didn't have a map, so I drew one myself. The first people I came across were two guys, old enough to remember Judgment Day. We camped out together. They gave me advice, we shared some stories. Sounds nice, right?
A little too good to be true.
It was. I was too naive to notice it back then. When I woke up, all my things were gone, including my map. There I was, lost in the desert. Thirst and hunger. I knew I was gonna die. I passed out with my face in the sand. But next thing, I was lying in a bed, bathed and wearing clean clothes.
You're lucky someone found you.
Someone did find me. Too bad it was Skynet. Through the window, I saw thousands of Terminators. First, I thought it was a work camp. But it was something else. A Skynet research facility. They kept me alive, but I didn't know why. I thought I was the only human there. But after a while, someone came into my cell. A man. Well-dressed, clean-shaven. You want to take a guess who that was?
An infiltrator.
In a way. He was a traitor to his race. Bastard was selling every piece of knowledge the machines didn't have. In return, they gave him everything he wanted. When he was done stuffing his face with food, he had another request. He wanted a whore. It lasted months until I got to wrap a towel around his neck and make his eyes pop. You don't want to see people for what they really are. I've seen their true face. That traitor, those two guys in the desert, Mac. They all showed it to me. It's not pretty. The truth is, the only reason I fight for the Resistance is because I despise people just a little less than the machines.
Anything I should know about Dr. Mac before I leave?
Only that he can't be trusted, and he's highly manipulative. So you need to stay cautious.
Jacob, are you receiving me?
You're alive!
No time for that. Do whatever it takes to get everyone out of that shelter. Do you understand? They're not safe there.
What? Why? God damn it! What does he mean? Get everyone out of the shelter? Dr. Mac! Is that you? The Resistance needs your help! Mac! It would be a shame to lose that camera.
Now, why would you do that?
Because we don't have time for this. Come out here! Skynet has developed a new Terminator model, the Infiltrator.
You've seen one already?
We've captured one, and we need your help. Are you there?
How do I know you're not an infiltrator? You've seen them. You know how incredibly lifelike they are, so you should understand my concerns. Head up that hill. If you want me to help you, you have to take a test for me.
Test?
Yes. To determine whether you're a Terminator or not. And be careful. I'm watching you. they're actually trying to fight you? Very clever way to make me think that you're not one of them. Unfortunately for you, I'm not that easily fooled.
We don't have time for any of this. Just tell me where you are. I am not a robot.
Living tissue would make you a cybernetic organism, not a robot. Words have meaning. Conversations between human beings would be a lot easier if we all just trusted each other and understood the deeper meaning of what we said. Keep that in mind during this test. Now, all eight of them. Well, I guess with you in there, that makes it nine.
I know it looks tempting, but please do not destroy that plasma container. It powers this whole laboratory. Sorry for making you run around like that. But because of the recent increase in Terminator patrols, I couldn't get to that Spider Scout myself. Can I see it? Thank you. I have a gift as a token of my appreciation. While you're out looking for my spider scout, I used some leftover parts to make a new radio for you. I've been picking up your signal for a while now, and I imagine that Skynet has as well. So, I've made it harder to decipher. You won't have to worry about them eavesdropping.
You've been listening, so you know why I'm here.
Yes. Now, let me see that gun. What a beauty. I've got to tell you, if Skynet wasn't so gung-ho about killing everything... What's interesting about it is that the matter inside is far more condensed. That way, it releases more energy on discharge, dealing much more damage. And also, its plasma blast is violent, so that's different.
Can you bypass the encryption lockout so we can use it? Alvin couldn't.
Alvin couldn't bypass an egg timer if his life depended on it. I'll do it, but it's not that simple. First, you'll have to bring me Skynet's latest security codes.
Security codes?
They will allow us to access Skynet's mainframe. But they change them regularly, so I need you to connect to any HK unit and download the newest security codes. To do that, you'll need my code reader. When I was excused from the shelter, they made me leave all my equipment behind. Alvin should have my code reader.
Okay, is that everything?
As far as the security codes go, yes.
Then I'm moving out.
Actually, I've got a question about that infiltrator that you have there. Is it intact? Or more specifically, its neural net CPU? I've been hacking Skynet's units and I'm noticing similarities in their patterns. I think I'm ready to reprogram the CPU from that infiltrator. It's more powerful than any other.
Should I ask Baron about that, too?
No, she can't know about it. She would not approve. I know how this sounds, but you need to steal it for me. What? I'm the only one that can reprogram that chip. For some reason, Skynet has started to learn at a geometric rate. We need to prepare ourselves for whatever's coming, and I believe that having an infiltrator on our side will give us the advantage. Just think about it.
Commander.
Rivers, what's the status?
Max alive. He will help us, but he needs a device he left at the shelter.
All right, we can do that. Report to me when you get back.
Over and out.
I have to say, you're doing quite well without my help.
What are you doing here?
You have to get the ones you care about to leave the shelter. They'll be in great danger if you don't do what I say. But remember, Jacob, that has to stay between us.
Why?
Because things need to play out the way they're supposed to, that's why. I have been here from the beginning. Each of your friends already knows the reason they need to leave. You just have to remind them.
Do you know anything about a CPU that Mac wants me to steal?
I do. If hacked, we could take over an infiltrator. Dr. Mack is capable of doing that. I'm not so sure if Alvin can. I think you should steal it. Can I tell Commander Baron? No, she won't allow it. Then she will start to question you and keep you away from your missions. That cannot happen. Who the hell are you? That I can't tell you. It could change the choices that you make in the future, and we can't have that. So whatever happens, you can't know my identity. Not yet, at least. I think I'm more confused than I was before. Just stay focused. We'll see each other soon. I am.
That's what I thought.
Commander.
The door behind you.
I really appreciate what you did for me. I won't bother you no more.
I've got the codes.
All right, then let's get right to it. Please insert stolen security codes now. Strike a key when ready. And it's done. Like they say, easy money.
That's it?
With the proper equipment, it only takes a moment. We can fight Skynet with our own weapons. I believe that goes for that infiltrator as well. The first prototype just came out a couple of days ago. Imagine what happens if they become mass-produced. We need to hurry before that happens.
That infiltrator has been after us for more than just a couple of days.
What do you mean?
It's been following me for months.
But that simply can't be. That prototype has been out for mere days.
It's the same model that destroyed Pacific Division.
But I'm connected to Skynet's mainframe and I can see their plans. I'm telling you that what you're saying is not possible. Unless... Oh my God. They will do it. They will finish the TDE.
Finish what?
TDE, time displacement equipment. For all intents and purposes, it's a time machine.
A time machine?
Yes, a time machine. You go in, you pick a date, you press a button, and just like that, you'll be watching your younger self learning to tie your shoelaces. You know, time travel. Skynet's been working on TDE for a while now. I've been monitoring its progress, but it's still not ready yet.
So how could they send anyone back if it's not ready?
They didn't, but they will. Don't you see? In one alternative future, they finished TDE and sent a Terminator back to our times. That has to be the one you saw. You couldn't have seen it otherwise. It didn't exist yet. That would explain why they suddenly started to learn at such a geometric rate. This is big. This is really big.
So if it's done, then what the fuck can we do now?
We can still fight for this future. Our future. You could stop Skynet before they finish building time displacement equipment and send any more Terminators back. I'm forwarding everything I've learned to Connor. He needs to know. And you go report back to Baron.
Speaking of Baron...
What are you doing?
Did Commander Baron order you to do this?
Please, please think about it. I'm the only one that can stop Skynet. You need me.
Commander.
I'm here. Is the thing with Mac taken care of?
It is. But I have some news for you.
Go ahead.
Here's the man of the hour.
Sergeant, are you taking a tour with us?
Back to me.
Know your target and what's behind it.
And what else?
Shit, I forgot.
They gave me a rifle? I don't even know how to use one. They said it's hot, but it doesn't seem hot to me at all.
This is it, huh? No more turning back. Whatever happens, you know what? It's probably bad luck to say goodbye, right?
Nervous? Don't worry, we'll be right behind you. Baron wants us to set up a field hospital, so if anything happens, I'll meet you there.
Rivers, just when you thought shit couldn't get any more crazy, this happens.
So what now?
With the infiltrators coming out and news of a fucking time machine, Connor wants to finish this war fast.
Are we prepared?
Nowhere near. That's why an all-out attack is our only option. Alvin managed to locate Skynet's central core through the hijacked satellite. It turns out it's right under our nose. It's in the basement of the old Griffith Observatory.
So we're moving out.
You are. Connor wants me to stay here to coordinate the attack. And his North Division is heading to stop Skynet from sending anything through the time displacement equipment.
So this is it?
It does seem that way. You better get all your things sorted. Take your time. You're leaving in a couple of hours. Dismissed.
Jacob, you're moving out?
I am. What about you?
I'm part of a scavenging team now, but Commander Baron gave us an order to get back to the shelter. If you see Jennifer, can you tell her that?
Okay. Where is she?
Last time I saw her, she was upstairs.
Nice view.
How did you find me?
Patrick told me you might be somewhere around here.
It's my thinking spot. Is he worried?
No, he seems happy. How did he do on your first scavenging hunt together?
Well, at first he was excited just to be outside. A little too excited. Some drones spotted him. But I did it. I managed to protect him. Nothing happened. And from that point on, he understood how dangerous a scavenger's life can be.
See, you'll make a great scavenging team.
Yeah, I'm starting to see it that way. And because of that, I was thinking...
About leaving?
I don't have any secrets from you, do I? Yeah, about leaving. With Patrick.
You know, I think you should stay. This is not a time to think about personal problems. There's a war to fight.
Spoken like a true soldier. But you know what? You're right. It's probably incredibly selfish of me to even consider leaving. Especially now this war is about to end. I'll stay. Support the cause. Maybe even start faking enthusiasm while talking to Baron. You're always looking out for me. Thank you for that. I know you're moving out soon, but there's something I want to say. Regardless of what happens later, I hope that we'll find each other. Thank you for always being there for me. I'm lucky to have someone like you.
And I'm lucky to have you.
I hoped you'd say that. You know what? I'll stay here just a little while longer. Tell Patrick not to worry. I'll be back soon.
I'll do that.
You ready to move out?
I am.
All right. Let's do this. Thirty years ago, the machines decided to wipe out all of humanity because they feared that we were a threat to their existence. Today, we make their fear come true. Sergeant Rivers, you were requested by John Connor to lead the Alpha Team. You will be responsible for carrying out the attack on the location of Skynet's central core. We will create a diversion to lure out any HK aerials patrolling the area. That should give you some time to breathe. Taking out Skynet's ground forces, that's on you. Remember, the goal is to destroy Skynet's central core, at whatever cost. Good luck out there. Dismissed.
one. This is us. Let's move out. We're 2 minutes out from the observatory. As soon as we get past that barrier, expect Skynet to show up. Stay focused. Silverfish, 12 o'clock.
Neutralized.
Let's keep moving.
Metals ahead!
Nice shot! We're through!
Keep pushing forward!
Metals!
Good shooting!
Another infiltrator?
No, he's with us.
Took you a while. How did you know we were coming? I thought you'd know by now. I know more than you think. Better prepare yourself.
Focus on that HK! They're coming from the west gate!
Get Central core is downstairs.
How do you know?
I've been here before. I've seen it.
Watch out!
Watch out!
This is it. Skynet's finished. It's supposed to be right here. They knew we were coming. They moved it. It's a trap. A fucking trap.
We have to move. Those missiles are headed this way.
Wait! If we triggered the attack, it means that this place is still connected to Skynet's mainframe. If we trace where the signal's coming from, we'll know the Central Core's actual location.
How could they know we were coming?
When Skynet was about to lose the war, they sent an infiltrator back in time. It must have warned them about this attack.
How do you know all this?
Because I went back after that infiltrator. Yes! I've got the coordinates. Let's go! All of this will make sense to you soon, but right now we need to go!
Commander, Central Core, it's not here. It was an ambush. Commander!
You can't die here. Get up!
Baron, I've got the coordinates. Can you hear me? Where the hell are you?
What the
Commander!
Rivers, you're alive.
What happened here?
An infiltrator got in. Brought lots of friends with him. We didn't stand a chance. Since they didn't go offline, I assume we did not destroy Skynet's central core either.
No. No, we didn't. It was an ambush. They moved it before we got there.
So this is it? We lost? We lost this goddamn war?
Not yet.
What do you mean?
I got the Central Core's real coordinates.
You have? I've gotta learn not to doubt you anymore, Rivers.
We need to call Connor. He may still be able to stop Skynet.
Forget it. I couldn't get him on the radio for hours. You need to find him. You need to give him those coordinates.
First, let's get you out of here.
No. You don't have time for this. You have to leave me here.
I can't.
You're not gonna disobey my final order, are you? Before you leave, I've got a confession to make. There's a reason I wasn't so keen on you from the beginning. Remember that list of people Skynet marked for termination? I lied. I told you that you were number three. The truth is, you're number two, just behind Connor. You took my spot, and for the life of me, I couldn't understand why. But now I know. They're coming. You need to leave, now. Use a vent in the command room to sneak past them, and then find Connor, and give him those coordinates. Don't worry about me. If they come here, I'll just reason with them. I still have a couple magazines full of arguments. Now go! Good luck, Jacob.
Died in that ambush trying to protect me. He came from the future to save my life, and I don't even know his identity. But thanks to his sacrifice, I managed to escape with the Central Core's true location. When I got back to the shelter, I realized that getting that information cost the life of many others as well. I headed out to find John Connor and his North Division to take part in the last all-out attack.
Anyone receiving me? This is Sergeant Jacob Rivers, DN46890. Anyone out there? If anyone's hearing this, please respond. Is anyone else out there?
Look, we got one.
He's wearing a resistance uniform.
Who did you kill to get that, you filthy machine?
No, don't! Wait, he's human!
Sorry about that, Sergeant. The infiltrators took some of our key positions, so we're extra cautious. If we'd known that you were joining us in the North Division, that would have never happened.
You know who I am.
We all do, Sergeant Rivers. John Connor told us about you. He said you'd come and bring those coordinates.
How did he know I'd have them?
That you'll have to ask him yourself. He's waiting for you upstairs.
He's the only survivor from Baron's division.
That's him. The one Connor's been talking about.
Sergeant.
Commander.
Sergeant Rivers, I've been expecting you. I took the liberty of collecting the Central Corps' coordinates you brought us. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all. Are we preparing to attack the Corps?
I've sent a unit to do that. We're getting ready to strike the time displacement equipment. Very soon Skynet will realize that they're losing this war, so they'll try to send infiltrators back in time to prevent that from happening.
Do we stand a chance?
Thanks to the security codes that Mac provided, we've been able to seize control of an HK tank for the first time. It should give us the advantage against Skynet's defense grid. We'll smash it once and for all. I understand that all this might be confusing to you, so if you have any questions, now's the time to ask them.
Why am I targeted for termination?
You're the one who discovered the true location of the Central Corps. You're the messenger of the intel that could lead to Skynet's downfall.
How did you know that the Central Corps wasn't at the observatory?
Understanding the changing nature of time travel made me anticipate the most unexpected events. So when I learned from a mutual friend of ours that a Terminator was sent back to our time, I suspected the future I was told would change.
What do you mean?
When that infiltrator connected to Skynet, it warned them about the attack on the observatory. They had to move the Central Corps, otherwise they would lose again. Unfortunately, the intel we received came at a cost. But if there was any other way, I would have taken it gladly.
Who is the stranger?
In one alternative future, we reached the time displacement equipment and sent our soldiers back in time. Like always, the mission was to assure the safety of the people Skynet marked for termination. One of whom was you. Knowing the importance of your mission, many volunteered to go back, so I took it upon myself to choose a protector from among them. And the one I chose was you. You are the one you call Stranger. I'm sure you'll figure out the rest when the time comes. But right now, I want you to get ready. Tonight, soldier, we stop Skynet.
...24 on their way to the Central Corps.
Then we better get ready.
Take whatever you need, Sergeant.
Sergeant Rivers, it's time. I want you to take a team of my soldiers and fight your way to Skynet's defense grid. We have to destroy those turrets to get to the TDE, but don't worry. We'll provide the support. It's in your hands now, Rivers. Follow me.
Commander?
Commander. Defense grid, I see it. Sector is secured.
All right, Rivers. Continue the offensive. We're preparing to send in the tank.
Watch out!
Zero in on that T-47!
Thank you. Another sector cleared.
That's good to hear, Sergeant. The HK tank just went online. You've got a
Imperial!
Down it!
T-47 ahead!
Two of them!
Sergeant, I got a visual on the defense grid turrets.
Commander, what's going on?
The 124 destroyed the central core and stopped Skynet.
So is the war over?
For some of us, yes. But just before we destroyed the core, Skynet managed to send three Terminators back in time. The only thing in our power now is to send the Protectors to meet them.
Protectors?
The ones that will assure the safety of the people marked for termination. The first Protector has to be Sergeant Kyle Reese. He'll go after the T-800 that's targeting my mother as we speak. By killing her, Skynet will try to erase me from ever existing. The second one will seek to destroy the T-1000.
T-1000?
A Terminator made of mimetic polyalloy, sent back to kill me as a child. A single prototype created by Skynet. It's too powerful for a single human being. That's why we'll have to send a Terminator of our own. Do you have that CPU that Mac reprogrammed?
No, I don't.
You don't? Then we've got a problem. I don't believe any of our soldiers are capable of stopping the T-1000. We'll have to find another way, and we have to do it soon. Then, there's the matter of the infiltrator that was sent after you. The war can end for you right now, but the question is, are you willing to sacrifice your future to protect your past? By being here, you've already proven that this is not beyond your capabilities. But I'll leave the decision up to you.
Will I be able to fix my past mistakes?
I always believe that the future's not set. There's no fate but what we make for ourselves. You do have the power to change it and protect the ones you care about. So, what will it be then?
I don't want to go.
I cannot judge you. You've seen yourself die once, and that's probably once too many. There are volunteers that will gladly take your place.
John Connor prepared the time displacement equipment to send protectors back in time. He knew that the final battle would not be fought here, but in the past. A resistance soldier named Kyle Reese was the first man to go back to 1984. His objective was to protect Sarah Connor, John's mother. There was no way a human could stand up against the more advanced T-1000. But without Dr. Mack to reprogram an infiltrator CPU, Connor would be forced to find another way to get a machine on our side. I've decided not to go back in time. Plenty of volunteers wanted to take my place. John Connor chose a man from amongst them. I only hope that he does a better job than I did. After 30 years, this war against the machines is finally over. But not all of us lived to see the end of it. We never found Baron's body in the shelter. She never stopped fighting. And if she's still alive, I doubt she ever will. She was the leader we needed in wartime. But I'm not sure if she'll find a place during this time of peace. Erin died in that shelter. She believed that her work was helping win the war, and she was right. I hope now she can finally rest. Ryan stayed in the shelter and died. He was a good man, with a good heart. Jennifer and Patrick died at the hands of Terminators in the shelter. I wish there was something I could have done to make them leave. I executed Mac. Baron was convinced that he was a threat to our cause. As a soldier, I've been taught to obey orders. But this time, I wasn't sure if it was the right decision. And as for me, it was time to start over.
Listen to me if you want to live. I couldn't have someone risk their life to protect me. That's why I decided to go myself. It gave me a chance to right the wrongs of my actions.